Hello, hello, hello. Looks like audio's working on my end. I hope. I think it is. If at any point something sounds bad or looks bad or whatever, please let me know. I'd appreciate that. So this is my first time streaming Weird Al. It's been a little busy for me. Just had a baby a month ago. Well, it will be a month technically on the 7th, but it's already been past 4 weeks as far as calendar days go. So been a little busy, which is why I've been kind of taking a break from doing all this stuff. But since there's some downtime, I thought, why not stream some Weird Al? Because this game is freaking awesome. I'm very, very, very happy that I got a P3 last year, because this game is, it's just such a blast. It's so good. Like, all the little weird things Al says, the callouts are amazing. The layout is really, really good. There's so many shots. And I found myself actually reverting back to having the flipper split on the different buttons, because having everything tied to the bottom, I should say having the flippers tied to one button on both sides, you block a lot of shots. And I do that on other games as well. But it's kind of nice with the ability to have them split that you can go back and forth. I know a lot of people don't like that. I kind of do now. So, why don't I just kick it off? I'm not good. Don't expect crazy deep stuff, because why am I in the service menu? That's weird. If you want to see the running with scissors and all that stuff, go to Buffalo Pinball. Watch Kevin's stream of that. He did all that. I'm not going to do that.
Welcome to the museum. Here,
I feel
and here,
like
and there, and there, and, well,
I'll turn the game up a little bit. There, we'll try 10. See how that does. All right. Of course, missed the skill shot. It's funny because whenever the ramp is not up, that spiral ramp, I have no problem. Ooh, I got VIP already.
You can go wherever you like.
I guess I'll do mission statement first. I like doing Weasel Stomping Day when I'm really close to doing like
Doggy Dog out there. So hit those financial targets.
Wow, what's it called?
Cash in when you count. Well, I guess you know everything.
Hardware store. Jeez. Come on, Ryan. When I have hardware store very close to being ready, because essentially Weasel Stomping Day is just hitting stand-ups. So if you could pull another multi-ball into that, then you can just bash those stand-ups and just rack your points up like crazy. My son plays this a little bit with me now, and after every time you drain, he goes, da-da-da-da-da-da, hey, and he always says hey, and it makes me laugh. Give it back. Yeah. Also, I hope everyone's having a fantastic Labor Day. Oh, nice, got VIP again. Let's do Amish Paradise.
Welcome to Paradise.
I had a wedding on Saturday, so it's kind of nice to have an extra day to still have off. All right, let's see. There we go. There we go. Get in there. Give me a Harvey. Hey! All right, let's see. Nowhere close to hardware store. I guess we'll just go for a mode and see what happens. Ugh, let's see how this drops the ball now. In there! Man, I'm ripping these VIPs. Well, it's the last ball. We'll just do Weasel Stomping today. Not enough oomph. So close. So all the blue stand-ups right now give me weasels. All right, finally got a Harvey lock. Down the middle. Hey! And that was a terrible score, so no high score. The cool thing with this game is, depending on what shot you hit on the playfield, when you knock down that drop-down target and you go in there, you'll start a mode. But you only get two modes to choose from. Go away. However, if you hit the VIP stand-up targets, then the two of the walls and scoops pop up, and then you shoot in there, and then you could pick from any of the modes that you want. So if you're trying to go through all the modes, and you want, or you want to play specific modes, it's best to hit the VIP targets and then go in there to choose whatever you would like. That's what I like about the game. There's so many. You have a lot of latitude with how you can play it. It's not, it's very unlinear. Skill shot. Tasty. Super skill shot. Super and we got a. Man. Getting a UHF lock out of the gate is awesome. So we got VIP already. There we go.
VIP.
I really like Mission Statement. It's a cool mode.
It's doggy dog out there. So hit those financial targets. Well, I guess you know everything.
So if you you double flip to cancel out the explanation, he always says some smart ass comment. It makes me laugh. Oh. All right, supply closet is mystery award, and we're getting UHF multi-ball. Oh no, it's just a lock. Never mind. So sometimes they'll give you like the whole multi-ball. Other times, up. So the mystery award gave me my second lock, and then I physically locked the third one. So.
Readmit.
Ah, come on. Flipper assist. Harvey lock.
Harvey lock is whipped. Camera lock is whipped.
Oh, come on. You gotta sell when you gotta sell.
You're a risk averse. You can leave any
time. Oh, come on. Yeah. So, after you progress enough, you can. It's kind of a risk reward thing. You can actually hit the drop target again where you start the mode and leave the mode. Or you can keep playing like I am. But now, so I hit that drop down target, so if I go in there, it's going to end the mode. Oh, nice. Give me a Harvey lock.
Use the hamster wheel.
So there's a... There we go.
Ball to lock.
So in front of the hamster wheel is a target for Harvey. And if you... I think the first time you hit it, it'll qualify the lock. Or not, I should back up. It'll raise up one of the scoops. Shoot the scoop. Then it raises the target because the lock's qualified. And I think subsequent times you have to, for each lock, you have to hit the Harvey target more. So you want to keep locking balls in Harvey. And I just wasted that. Those on the drain.
Don't do
it allowed on the museum floor. No! Board dog, how's it going? Good to see you. Hope you're having a fantastic Labor Day. But you're retired, so it's kind of like every day's Labor Day, right? So now that I have the hardware store qualified, which is the very back of the playfield shot, I don't want to hit that ideally until I have a mode going, which would have been perfect for Weasel Stomping Day.
Any day now.
So let's see, how do I want to do this? You're down to 11 and a half months to your P3. Awesome. Hey, it's going to go by quick. And it may come quicker. Maybe. You never know.
Ball fade. Shoot the ticket counter. That's a meal ticket.
Okay, so we can do word crimes or I'll sue ya. I guess we'll do I'll sue ya.
All right, excuse me. The mezzanine is open.
All right, so hardware store is being brought in to the mode. And yes. To me. All right. That's, I mean, maybe Board Dog, but think of the memories. And I got a free pass at least. Shazam! I'm just trying to lock it. Nope. But, oh, come on. That was stupid. I am looking forward to people like you, Borg Dog, getting their P3s and making games because obviously, the more people get into the platform that it can develop stuff, the better it is for everybody. Like, what Nick's doing is fantastic. Death Gun, I love this game. A lot. Like,
it's a big red button on the front of the machine.
I don't want to say something that's, like, hyperbolic sounding, but I don't have a Godzilla, and I really, really would like a Godzilla, and I'm totally okay with having this over Godzilla. This game, it's just super fun, and, like, what's the right word? Like, I appreciate all the humor in games, like, all the Elvira games, and, like, Midnight of Madness, Attack from Mars, that kind of stuff, and this game is all that, like, exponentially. It's just goofy, weird, funny, but beyond that, like, everything is fun to shoot. It feels good. That corkscrew ramp is a blast. There's so many diverters in this game, and I'm a big fan of heavy diverter usage because it takes the same real estate and makes it do all sorts of different things, and this game is full of it. We buy pinball. Yeah, I agree. I'm a big fan. Like, I like it a lot. I bought the P3 last year. I think I placed my order in June and I got it in August of last year. So I got a P3 before Weird Al was even a thing. I didn't know about it. I think even before I even, I don't know how to word it. Before they even announced there was even going to be a licensed game, I bought the P3, mostly because I wanted Heist, and I wanted to play Cosmic Kart Racing online with other people, and I really also wanted Ranger in the Ruins. So I got a P3 before even Sorcerer's Apprentice was released. And I was so happy I got Cosmic Kart Racing since that game is module specific. Yeah, and Cactus Canyon. Thank you, Borg Dog. I forgot about how funny Cactus Canyon is. But, like, look, I just nailed that. Like, a lot of people talk about how hard it is to hit, and it's like anything. You gotta time the shot. So. And, of course. Heist or Weird Al? Man. Pay attention to the music right here. This is a Scott DeNisi original. Heist or Weird Al? I think, honestly, it's tough, but I would go Weird Al because of the humor is that much more ramped up compared to Heist. But, I mean, Heist has enough humor by itself. But this is just, like, loaded with humor. I'll drop it down a little bit again. The shots are awesome on Heist as well. And to be honest, I think the shots on Cosmic Kart Racing are buttery smooth, too. Because I have... Those are the three modules I have. Weird Al, Heist, and Cosmic Kart. I'm really looking forward to seeing Nick Baldrige's module Drained. From what I hear, it sounds like something I will probably get. But overall, I'm very happy with the P3. Is it a lot of money? I think at this point, all pinball is a lot of money if you're talking new in box. So the price kind of goes out the door, really. I mean, it's money. I'm not going to act like it's, you know, we're all pulling money off money trees in our backyards and buying whatever we want. But if you're going to spend that kind of money, it's all kind of in the same boat at that point for me. So there's so much versatility and value with the P3, in my opinion, and another thing too is, as someone who wants to see technological advancements in pinball, like, I'd be a hypocrite to not get a P3. Like, I got one and I don't regret it. It's awesome. I have people come over periodically that have never played one. I'm like, please, everyone locally has an open invite to come check the P3 out. And one of my friends, Rob, did come over, and he ended up buying a P3. He bought actually a used one locally. Someone about 2 hours away was selling their... I think all they had was Heist. Heist, and they downloaded Rocks. And it was this style cabinet. No, we buy pinball. I'm at a point now where I have to sell pinball machines to get more pinball machines. And after just having a baby, I'm going to have to sell pinball machines to pay for a baby.
Welcome to the museum. Shoot here. And
but
here.
I...
And there. And
if you haven't played a P3...
You know, just shoot stop.
Please go check it out. It's, and especially if you can find someone or go to a show where they have multiple modules to check out, that is the way to do it. And that's kind of why I have an open invitation to anyone. It's like, hey, come over and like play it in a home environment where you can like get the full experience, especially like with this game in particular. There's so many funny little call-outs and just nuanced things that in a home environment, that's where you're going to hear it. And I feel like if you check it out at a show, it's going to be a little harder to get that immersion. Oh, of course, it moved. So... Finally... There we go. What? I totally didn't lock the ball. Maybe I had something else going on. Oh, you know why? I wonder... No, I don't think it was lit. Because there's like an order of operations where, like, if I would have had UHF, because the locks share the shot, and one supersedes the other. And I hit the wrong flipper button. But I wonder if that diverter would have pulled that ball in. Let's see.
Shoot the ticket counter.
All right. Nope, not enough oomph. I do that a lot. We're gonna call this game a mulligan. The whole game. Just psh, drain the next ball, get going. Oh, come on. Ball save at least. All right. Huh. Give me your shirt. And not enough oomph. And drain. But I would say if you're going to get a P3, I would spend the money on Weird Al and Heist for sure. And then after that, see, I did not pull the trigger on the other modules with at the lower price point, and
welcome to—
I'm sure that's going to be a big regret of mine. It just depends on my mood. I mean, Weird Al's the, you know, the new hotness, so that's been in here since I got it. And I got this game beginning of July, I got my module. I've probably had it for 2 months. So Weird Al's been in here for 2 months, and the reason I haven't swapped it out is because
hey, you in the face.
I also have Rocks, Barnyard. I think those are the only two that— oh, and I have Shoot and Scoot, and those three games can be played in any module. So when my kids come down here, they love Barnyard. I mean, like, they love it because they're 4 and 2, so Old McDonald to them is amazing. So even though I don't have to change the modules for that, I can still play up the— I think with this module I can play 4. So Weird Al, Barnyard, Rocks, Shoot and Scoot, so 4. With Cosmic Kart I can do 6 games, because I can do Cosmic Kart, Sorcerer's Apprentice, Rocks, Shoot and Scoot. Did I say Barnyard? Ranger in the Ruins. I think out of all the modules right now, Cosmic Kart has the most games available to play. But anyway, the point is, you can leave one module and still play multiple stuff. So, oh, come on. Boo. Just trying to lock a ball. Yes. Another thing, too, with these VIP targets, if you don't put the ball in within 8 seconds, gosh, let's do germs. the drop the stand the scoops drop down, and you actually lose 50,000 points for not collecting the VIP pass, which is pretty cool. So I need to turn the red ones green by rolling the ball over them. But you also break the Petri dish by getting real crazy. So I need to do nine. No. I need to hit 11 more. This mode, it's just so cool. Oh, come on. Every mode is completely different from one another, and that's what's awesome. There's no, like, sameness to them. Ah, not enough oomph. I was hoping that would have hit the magnet, and the magnet would have gave it a boost over. Nice. VIP again.
Pick any exhibit. Hey, that's handy.
Yeah, there's different things you can play for each one. How close am I? Oh, I'm not even close to a hardware store. How about like a surgeon? Play something different.
These patients are fading fast. Be precise with a scalpel, or you'll hear that heartbeat for the very last time.
Poor dog. So I'm not using... I'm not using my expensive camera for the play field because for whatever reason I get the distortion on the screen and I cannot figure it out for the life of me, so I'm using my handy cam for the screen and I'm using my expensive camera on my face. So apologies for having my face in better HD. I'll go back and I'll look at it. But you could be absolutely right. It's definitely got a lighter, more washed out look with this handycam. But it's also more clear in general. That's why I had to use it. Mystery award, what do we get? Oh, we get the whole multi-ball. Which is great, because I have nothing going on with it, so it's just a multi-ball all on its own. Board Dog, I'm not sure. I would assume it is. And that's how you waste a UHF multi-ball. To be honest, my favorite multi-ball, which I've not gotten yet, is the Harvey multi-ball. Because it's the Dare to be Stupid song, which is one of my favorite Weird Al songs. And, ball one, and we're on ball three, so awesome. But the cool thing about the moat is you hit the loop underneath the camera, and that spins the Wheel of Stupidity from UHF. Or no, the Wheel of Fish. And then you get all these goofy little power-ups while you're playing. Oh, come on. Down the drain. I'll check it out, Board Dog. But I mean, you could tell by when you look at the direct capture of the back box and what my camera's picking up on the screen, like you can tell the colors are a little off.
Welcome to the museum. Explore the halls. Play the mode.
Let's see. I really want to do a Harvey multi-ball. The ticket counter is open.
That's a meal ticket.
Oh, come on. And 7 food items, all right.
More food. Hey, the ticket booth is available.
Ah, missed it.
Head to the cafeteria.
Ah. Preemptively open a ticket now, Board Dog. Open it now and then backdate it. Oh, come on. I'm just totally missing all these shots. Good God. How's the audio, by the way? Is the game too quiet, or is it... I'm sure it'll get muted, since it's all copyrighted. Oh, come on, you jerk. Oh. And I missed the Herbie lock. Nice. If there's anything you're learning right now is that anyone can play this game much better than I can. And if you really want to see some depth, just go watch Kevin on Buffalo Pinball. I'll turn it up a notch. Hopefully it won't start rattling the glass. Let's see. Let's see. We'll try that out.
Welcome to Weird Al's Museum of Natural.
It's like with this game with the volume, like there's a big difference between 1 and 2 notches in volume, so that's why you kind of gotta be a little careful with it.
The ticket counter is open.
All right, Ooh.
Hey!
Ball 2 and 22,000 points, not good. All right. Don't go down the middle on me.
Shoot the hamster wheel.
I'll shoot the hamster wheel. Yeah, give me a combo.
Shoot the ticket counter.
Or go for the right out lane.
Hey.
I feel like that. 2 games back was not a bad game, all things considered, as far as getting through some progress.
Shell shot! More food! closet. Harvey lock his whip.
All right. Or we'll go right for the supply closet. Oh.
We need to save the station.
All right. Caught on the boo. Just flailing. I was trying to get a Harvey lock. Alright, we got a ball finally locked. Alright, and UHF locked. Let's do word crimes. Finny Blank, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate that.
For today's test. Okay.
Oh, since someone did something like that, did you hear a notification at all? Because I've been having problems with my notifications, and I thought I fixed it, but maybe I didn't. And drain. Well, at least we tripped over the million point mark. Hey, Mark, how's it going? You saw it, but you don't think you heard anything. Okay, I'll have to go back and look at that again. I thought I had it working, but... Okay, thank you. I'll have to get that going again, or figure it out at least.
Welcome to the museum. Explore the halls, play the modes, and enjoy the music.
We will enjoy the music.
Harvey lock is lit!
Yes. The cool thing they did too is initially there was no ball save for the Harvey lock, and occasionally it will give you a center drain depending on how the ball comes out of the mechanism. So they gave you like a 3 second ball save, which is awesome because enough people complained about it, myself included.
Meal ticket.
Oh! Yeah, you want to get some combos to get your multipliers up. Which obviously I'm not that good at. Alright, come on. And down the drain. Man, it must have hit like just perfectly to bounce off the guides and not go in the scoop for that mold start. Don't put on the... Thank you.
That's a meal ticket. The hamster wheel is ready.
So we have one Harvey Lock. Let's go for a drain. Well, that misery's over. We'll get another game going.
Welcome to Weird Al's Museum of Natural Hilarity. I hope you enjoy it!
And it's funny because even though he'll say the same things, he'll do different inflections and different, like, I don't know. It's fun. It kind of breaks things up.
Shoot the ticket counter.
All right.
The Hall of Crime and Punishment.
I'll do a Suya.
All rise. Court is now in. Excuse me.
Come on. And if you've never played a P3, they're very heavy, so your nudge game will need to be a little bit more... three times as hard. I'll put it that way. Shatsed it right to the outlane. All right, let's try that again. My brain was thinking the ball was going to come off this flipper quick and bounce over, and I could. That's why I did what I did, and that's not what happened. That is not what happened.
Welcome to the museum! Explore the hall! Play the boats and enjoy the music!
The other cool thing about this game is there's almost always something you're working towards.
Harvey Lock is lit.
So there's Harvey Locks, there's broken things for hardware store, there's collecting shirts, there's collecting spatulas. There's going for UHF multi-ball. And that's all outside of the normal modes.
It's dog eat dog. Well, I guess you already know everything. We must all efficiently operationalize.
There we go. And if you didn't know, the animation you're seeing on the screen is the actual video of the song.
Welcome
All right. I don't have any cool save states like Kevin to show you, like, end game stuff. What do we get?
You know,
so we get one lock.
Head to the ticket count. Eat it.
Ah. Nope. See if I can make ball three matter.
Skill shot. Super skills. Super duper.
Ho ho ho. Super duper. Oh, ball save. Thank you. I need an I and a P.
Apple lock is lit. Head to the ticket booth, the C exit.
Really?
Use the hamster wheel.
Okay. Let's see if I can.
Head to the cafeteria. Ball two locked.
All right, we got two balls locked.
Hey, the ticket booth is available.
I heard that.
Mmm.
So if I go for the eye, or I can miss it, and we can do, let's do white and nerdy. Again, there's two ways to start modes. It's hitting the VIP targets and going into the scoops here, or hitting the drop down in front of the mode start scoop itself. And if you do the VIP, you can pick any mode you want instead of just the two that it gives you. I like that ball had some promise. There's some traction being made. Too little, too late, of course.
Welcome
as always.
TV. Shoot here, here, there. It will fit to shoot stop.
There we go. Thanks, Upper Flipper. Yes. Okay. So we got VIP ready here. All right, so let's do a mode we haven't done yet. We haven't done sports song, I don't think. In the hour of me flailing, missing everything. Boo.
You
this man, he's terrible.
That could have been a good ball.
Oh.
Shoot the ticket counter.
Get in there.
Harvey Lock is lit.
All right, so I think we have one Harvey Lock. Let's see. All right, two. Good. There's potential to see an actual Harvey Multiball. Let's do... I'll sue ya.
Oh, excuse me!
Ugh. Totally missed the pops. Just going for stand-ups. Oh, come on, really? Come on. There we go. Maybe I can pull Harvey in now? Come on, come on. No! Yes! So now, with this multiball, I want to hit this loop underneath there to spin the wheel. You know, like I'm not doing. There we go. Reverse flippers. Shoot. Oh, inverted. Oh, it's inverted. So you have to push in. It's so weird. What do we got here? A Harvey Lock. All right. So the inverted flippers, instead of being, you know how Simpsons and Houdini have reverse flippers? Well, with inverted, you, oh, come on, it wouldn't give it to me. You have to push the button in and, how does it work? So letting go of the button flips, pushing in lets it drop down. So it's like the opposite of what you think it is. No, I wasted it. The upper flipper, man, I'm not sure if that's inverted. I want to say it is because it's all tied together. So this upper flipper and that upper flipper are on the same button. So that's another thing to make note of if you ever get a P3 and you want to tie all the buttons together for the flippers. You cannot tie the upper flipper to the bottom button. You still have to use the upper flipper button on the side of the cabinet. Unless they change that at some point, but currently that is not the case. So our hardware store is ready. I do not want to use that until I start a mode. And like I said, I feel like So all I need is the V for VIP. And I missed it. Come on. Ugh. All I had to do was hit that little stand up there to hit VIP, and I missed it. Like I said, this is like the perfect multi-ball to bring in for Weasel Stomping Day. The ticket counter. Ah, oh, boo.
Hey, the ticket booth is available.
Sure thing, we buy pinball. Must have weeby. Thanks for hanging out and stopping by. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day. Hope you didn't have to go to work. I certainly will. Although I will be cutting the lawn very shortly after I end the stream, which at least I can do it not after work. Let's see, what time is it?
Welcome to the museum. Here and here and there. And there. I'll just shoot stop. Admittance at Alstar.
See if I can get that. Oh, man. There we go. Harvey Lock. Or not. Oh, that was the problem. It wasn't qualified.
Meal ticket.
I thought that's what happened before as well. The ramp was not qualified when I thought it was. Because I was paying attention to the wrong insert. Now that the arrow is flashing orange, it's qualified. Okay.
All health and medicine. Please.
Well, have fun mowing your lawn. And hopefully it goes off without a hitch and there's no
world of germs.
Fingers or toes missing.
Hey. Uh-oh. Don't break through the glass. That's one state I've never in.
All right, we need some more. There we go, now there's three.
This is our last beat for you.
Two more.
Wait, replicating, look out!
All right.
Who's
gonna clean up this messy? No! And down the drain. Kevin, what's going on? Hope you're having a fantastic Labor Day. I hope you're not laboring.
Hey, with a supply slot.
Okay, yeah, and I kind of looked off to the sideboard, dog, to see, and I could see the difference, but again, like I said, I'm not using my nice camera on the playfield because I, for the life of me, cannot figure out how to get rid of the distortion lines from the monitor. I'm at my wit's end with it, so I just use the handy cam. Good, Kevin. I'm very happy to hear that. Anytime you're not laboring is a good thing, I think.
Don't go anywhere.
Okay. What we got? I'll take it. Any extra points I'll take. UHF live!
Stand by, everyone. Counter.
Yeah, Kev, you streaming tonight? Oh, look at that accidental ricochet.
Well, you can go wherever you like.
I'm just gonna do mission statement. And your wardrobe will be on point. Nice.
It's Doggy Dog out there. Oh, well, I guess you already know it.
Yes, I do. I do know the game. I just can't execute it.
Hamster wheel is ready. Ball one locked. Camera locked.
Ugh. Ooh, I thought I lost it. And then I actually did lose it. Ah. The emote gives away the shirt. Ball 3 of 3.
Well, you're hungry. The ticket counter is open.
So the one thing you can learn while watching me is what not to do. So don't use your upper flipper to weakly hit the ball and send it to your left out lane. And I would probably say the same thing about the left flipper. Don't put it to your right out lane.
It's showtime! Readmittance at no charge. Please choose an exhibit.
Sure. Word crimes.
Stop! Grammar time! For today.
Okay.
The hamster wheel is ready! The lock is lit!
Just need to hit C. Oh, Kevin, that is something I'll have to not partake in. I need to get to that point first. There we go. Like a surgeon.
These patients are fading for now. Well, I guess you already know. No, don't do that.
See if this guy dies or not.
I'm
All right. I'll take it. Need some bologna. Let's just do weasel stomping. I have so far to go. I'm only halfway to getting hardware store, so. Just missed it. There we go. Goran, what's going on? If only I would have drained, then looked over, it would have been perfect. Goran, how's it going?
Get ready to museum!
I hope, like Kevin, you are also not laboring. Oh my gosh.
The mezzanine is open! The ticket counter is open!
Get in there. Ah.
Enter the ticket booth to see an exhibit. Here's a shirt.
Oh, that's how you miss Harvey. Or starting back up again. And then drain.
Hey!
Nice. I'm taking it easy as well. Apparently not drinking my beer because it's like 3/4 full that I cracked right before I started. Peanut butter and jelly beer. It's actually really, really good and I love it.
The big red button on the front of the machine.
But I didn't do much today. I went shopping with my daughter. Or I shouldn't say shopping. Went to the grocery store with my daughter. She really wanted to get out of the house, so I took her. Stream a little pinball. After this, I'm going to cut the lawn, and then we're going to grill some brats, and that's about it. No, Boar Dog, it is actually really good. It's shockingly... It tastes like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich with a bunch of alcohol in it. It is... How they got the flavoring down so good is... It's sorcery. Tracy from Outer Spacey, how's it going? Good to see you. Hope all is well. How's the weather down in Texas? You can have that as well, Goran. It's delicious. How to word this? Is it Skippy? Dave's not here, so no, not Skippy. We are going to grill those brats. Mr. Silver... Just playing this game you helped make. It's fantastic. Thank you. You should make more awesome games like this. I'll keep giving you guys money. Oh, I would say beats 106 for sure. Worky lurky, I got you. You gotta do that. I mean, it is Labor Day. They can't expect you to work too hard if you gotta be there. So my friend has like a hobby farm, I guess, kind of. And they raise cows, and they started raising pigs to be butchered and sold. And we have gotten half cows and quarter cows in the past. And my friend's like, well, if we raise pigs, do you want to get some pork. And we'd never done it before. And we're like, eh, sure. So I was like, well, how much meat do you get from a half pig and a whole pig compared to, like, a cow? Because obviously a cow is, like, 4 times bigger than a pig. And when I found out how much meat a whole pig was, I was like, just give me a whole pig because it's not that big. So we have so much bacon, brats, ham, pork chops, pork steaks, sausage. I picked it up like a week ago and we made the bacon this morning for the first time. Super thick cut smoked bacon and it was awesome. It has like that awesome bacon flavor, but it's not loaded with salt. Like it has some salt because to preserve it, but like the stuff from the store is like crazy salty to me, and this is like just phenomenal. So we're gonna try the brats tonight, and then I think sometime during the week we'll try the pork chops probably. So, but I'm very happy with all the stuff we got so far. And if you're joining
the ticket counter
more recently compared to when I started, you will not see very deep game stuff for me. If you want that, go to Buffalo Pinball, watch Kevin. Kevin can do that. I am just someone who likes pinball, but it's terrible at it, and had enough money to buy a Weird Al, so this is what you get. How about I don't flail? That'd be cool. I've been playing with the idea of getting another mirrorless camera. That way I can have one here and one above the playfield, because if this one's gonna be a problem with the P3, I wanna see if another brand would be better that maybe would eliminate the problems I'm having with this one. But we'll see. We did War Crimes last, I think. We'll do I'll sue you.
All right, use me.
Okay, 3 flips and not one. 4 flips and not one thing made for progression. Good, good. Good, good. Good. This is fantastic. Again, I'm showing you what to not do. There we go. Finally, something that helps the mode. Hmm. Can I actually? Let's see if I can start a hardware store. All right. Come on.
You can settle out of court if you want. I share it. My, where did you get that lovely spatula?
I just want to go for the hardware store. Oh my gosh. Or I'll just end the mode. Get it out of here. Dave's Arcade. This guy's on vacation watching pinball.
one
locked. Oh, ball one locked on ball three of three. Boo! You got a new game on vacation? I would never have thought Dave you would have done something like that. Wait, is it when you just said game, you mean pinball machine game or do you mean like a board game? Because that can be.
This place needs repairs, I'm afraid.
Should have brought your truck, okay. So it's a big game. Wait, is it a big game? Should have bought mine. One. Boo. Nah. Boo. No!
You know, there's more to the museum than this room. Head to the ticket counter.
Okay, I'll go to the ticket counter. Secret Service, Dave? Oh, yes! That is so awesome. You should also get Data East Time Machine, and then when you are sick of both Secret Service and Time Machine, I'll buy those. It's a win-win for everybody. Yeah, Secret Service is... That's like one you don't see very often, but it's like a guilty pleasure. Like, it's just fun to shoot. All right. We'll go again.
Welcome to the Museum of Natural Hilarity.
Steven, how many hours did you say... Yeah, Al was in the booth. Gosh. Oh my gosh. Well, you know, they say seventh time's a charm, right? You murdered his vocal cords. Oh, that's awesome. Well, you're a fantastic vocal cord murderer, because everything... One of my favorite things about the game is all the callouts. It's just so cool. I'm sure he will love to see you. He'd be like, what? Or you go see me, he's like, who are you? What? Yeah, we made your pinball machine? Like, I don't remember that at all. I'm a busy guy, all right?
Shoot the ticket counter.
Oh, not enough oomph.
Head to the ticket booth, see an exhibit.
Or the ball's gone, and I can't do that.
Yoga! Super duper!
Yes. Super duper! Whoa, that ball jumped!
The ticket counter is open! Welcome to School of Anthropology. Please choose
a number. We'll do Amish Paradise. Very awkward. Very awkward.
Welcome to Paradise, heathen. We've handcrafted a replica of your immoral flipper machine, only less electro and more mechanical. The goal is scoring points for the afterlife with hard work and chores.
Heathen. I want to let that one play out. All right, finally, something. Finally. Hardware store, huh? All right. Yes. I did something. Come on.
Check on the exit door.
All right, we'll get out of the mode. Cash out while we can. All right. I think I'm just flailing right now, hitting nothing of substance. Right up the middle. You can do it. Right up the middle. There we go. Okay.
VIP. Oh,
all right. Man, if I was about to go into hardware store, I'd do Weasel Stomping Day. Why don't we just do Sports Song? Why not?
Hitting our shots was great.
Hey, Sarah,
guess you're all set.
Give it back. All right, sweet. Oh, I thought that was a Harvey lock. I really like when he's like, nom 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 nom. It makes me laugh. So I kind of do that to my kids, to be a weirdo. No! No! And down the drain. That's right, Skip. How's it going? I didn't get a chance to stick around and watch you play that sweet game as much. I had to do some stuff around the house and go grocery shopping. Alright, how about I'll do one more game and then I really have to get out there and cut the lawn. I've been kind of dragging my feet on it. Skip, overall, we're doing good. The baby's kind of sleeping a little more at night, which is fantastic. It's weird. I'm like, don't you like sleeping, kid? I love it. You're going to love it. Why are you fighting this? I know. I should have did it earlier this morning and really pissed my neighbors off, but I got lazy myself. It's kind of hard to embark in that neighbor war with your lawn when you don't have the energy to even do it.
It's showtime!
At least when you miss the ramp, you can drain. I was gonna say hit the Harvey lock.
The wheel is ready. The ticket counter is open.
All right. Let's do a mode.
Business and industry.
I know, babies. What the heck? They don't do fun stuff. And on top of it, you get bills for having them. It's so weird. Actually, you know what pissed me off?
Dog out there, so hit those.
Within 2 days of being home, we were getting bills from the hospital. And they were like, oh, you should enroll your child in insurance. And it's like, yeah, I haven't been to work yet to even submit the paperwork, so why are you sending me bills for things you know I'm not going to pay you for? And I was like, you know, you guys would save a lot of money if you didn't send bills out that weren't necessary. Come on, come on, come on, come on! It's so expensive! Ah, I missed it! Ah, bummer. I'm just missing all my shots and draining. Oh, those scoops were worth so much, and I couldn't hit them to save my life. But that's what I like about these, some of these modes like this. It's just progression, progression, progression. What's his toes? How's it going? If my baby has a pause button, I have yet to find that. I'll have to work on that. Let's shoot the hamster wheel. Or miss the hamster wheel. If you play this game, hit the hamster wheel. It's a good idea.
Shoot the ticket counter.
Holding the baby flipper up and opening the coin door. So I hold the arm up and I take the diaper off. Is that how that works? I'm gonna take some notes.
Any day now.
I'll report back.
Harvey Lock is lit!
Oh my gosh, jerk.
Combo,
combo breaker! Did you see how I just kind of took the ball and I kind of just tapped it into the out lane? I've been working on that move for a long time. I feel pretty good about it. Well, I think with that, I'm going to pull the plug so I can go mow my lawn. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to lie. It's a skill getting the ball to just swish into the out lane without touching any posts or rubber or anything. Just smooth. I'm going to make some videos on how to do that. Anyway, we'll send you over to Chrome Candy. Thanks everyone for hanging out with me, even though I normally don't stream much anymore for the time being. Don't worry. I'll get back to it. But it means a lot. Happy to see everyone. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You are all the reason why I do this. Clearly it's not for my skills. Anyway, see you guys around.